Yo, what's up people? Today I have part 2 of the How to Snipe Guide in Iron Sight for you all. Thank you for your support on the last video. It had like 62 likes, which is insane. And we already are on our way to 10,000 subscribers, as you guys can see. So keep up the support, smash like, subscribe for more, and let's get into part 2 of the How to Snipe Guide. By the way, if you haven't watched part 1 yet, go watch that one first. I will link it in the video description for you. Otherwise, part 2 will not make any sense to you. So, let's go! And I want to tell you guys, the harder you make it for yourself to learn something, whenever you do learn it, you're the best at it. So if you go easier on yourself afterwards, it will become the best thing ever. I want to ask you guys not to take any shortcuts. So don't go use the balance perk. This does not reduce your recoil, but the sway, by the way, and it will help you hold your breath longer by 100%. But if you get used to this crutch perk, you won't ever be able to transition back to quick switch or quick aim. So try not to use shortcuts. Don't use perks or attachments that makes it easier for you to aim a weapon. Just try draw and get used to it and get better like that. And afterwards, if you're good already and you switch to balance, you will get a lot better. You can get something out of it. So that would be my advice about no shortcuts for this. And now for the combos. So you have a secondary weapon, you have a DSR. I use this combination as I play for clips. I only play for clips and high kill gameplays. I want to win the game. I hold choke points and I snipe, quick switch to my bow and kill someone with the bow, switch back to my DSR and kill him with that. That's how I play. But if you have a different playstyle or you play different objective game modes, you need other loadouts to compete. As for the Blazer, Blazer is a hit marker machine. That's why I don't advise you to use the Blazer to get good with sniping or quickscoping, as it's a lot harder with the Blazer than with the DSR. The DSR gives you more one-shot headshots or one-shot body shots. The Blazer gives you a lot more hit markers even if you hit the enemy in the arm. So stay with the DSR for now, and I will give you some loadouts for the Blazer as well, and it will be exactly the same. That's the secret. I use the same loadout for every one-shot sniper. For automatic rifles, automatic snipers, I use them more like an assault rifle. That's something different. Those videos will come up later for semi-auto weapons. But for this one, just use one sniper. Be consistent at it before you switch to the Blazer or in the future to the JTAG, to the L96A1. Just stay with one sniper and get good with that. And later on, the transition will be much easier to other snipers. For the combos, you can go with the combat crossbow, but I would advise you not to do this. This is a really advanced loadout. I would go with a pistol you like. I like the PX4 Storm a lot, as it has a lot of bullets in the magazine. It has 13 bullets in the magazine. And the reason I would advise you to take a pistol or a shotgun is if you snipe and you do hit marker someone, you can quick switch to your pistol and finish them off that way. Or you miss your sniper shot and he's too close up to rebolt the sniper so you can shoot again. You switch to your pistol and you try to kill him that way. It's your way of surviving. And the bow is really easy to use, but you need practice with that as well. So first must is a sniper, and after that combo it with the crossbow one, because that's a sniper as well. So do that later, please. Just use a pistol or a shotgun, and I would advise you to go with a pistol for short to medium ranges. And the shotgun is, yeah, same as the sniper. You miss one, you need to clock the shotgun again, and then you can die. The most game modes are the same. You respawn, you kill some enemies, you die, and you respawn. But what if you play S&D? I would advise you to go, instead of quick switch, go to quick aim. Or nimble hands, as you can plant and defuse 30% faster and throw your lethals and tacticals faster. You can use quick reload, you can use balance, as you just need one good shot. You don't need to be rushing and killing enemies as fast as you can. You need to hold choke points, but an S&D video is coming up in the future. I'm not gonna talk about that very much longer. So try to make a loadout for yourself for the game what you play. For the keybinds, this is how I have set up my keybinds right now. Primary weapon selection is wheel up. Secondary, I don't have it. Melee weapon is my mouse button, the front one. Lethal tactical is 4. Last weapon is Q. This is the most important thing as a sniper. I will show you how I do it in a custom lobby as well, but I use Q to switch to my secondary and quickly switch back to my primary. That allows me to shoot faster, and yeah, it's kind of like a timing, like music, you know, like tap, 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 tap. It's just the rhythm of gameplay. You shoot, you double tap Q, and you're ready to shoot again. It just gives me some consistency and a pattern of gameplay, and it makes me a better sniper in my opinion. And all the other keybinds don't really matter to the sniping tutorial, so I will leave it. And for the movement, most of them is just the same. Control for prone is just default. Action key is on C and wheel down. I use wheel down to pick up weapons, and I can't defuse bombs with it, so I have it bound to C as well. And I crouch with my first mouse button closest to me, and I hold my breath with shift. I hold and I hold to crouch and sprint, so nothing is press to go sprint or crouch. Imagine there's an enemy, you got a few scenarios for you. You shoot him, you miss your shot. Now you have to wait till you can shoot again, as the sniper is a bolt action sniper. So what do? I snipe, switch to my pistol, and I'm ready to shoot him, to finish him off or just kill him if I totally miss my sniper. But most of the times I got so confident, what I do right now is I snipe someone. See what I mean? I'm just shooting, switching back so I can shoot again. I just do the weapon switch for canceling the animation. So instead of this, he is pulling back and coming back, and I can shoot again. I do. So I can already go scope in easily. You can also stay like this. But I want to be able to see my surroundings after I shot. And that's why I shoot, switch and move around for my next target, and shoot, move around for my next target, and don't want to wait on animations. As when you shoot and the animation of the sniper is going off, you cannot sprint. So shoot, try to sprint, it doesn't work. And afterwards you can sprint again. Let me reload this thing. But when I do this, I can directly sprint again. That's really important on surviving for a sniper. Holding breath and your timing with it is important as well. And in combination with your sprint key. As I run, this is how I walk, and I run, I hold shift in. But if I start scoping in, it immediately makes me hold my breath as well. And the timing of it is important to stabilize the sway a little bit. So when you do this, I'm too late with holding my breath. So I have to wait till it focuses so I can shoot. But when I time it right, I have to stand still to show you guys. It's only fair. It's a lot faster. As I have to wait, there's a little delay if you do it too late. So don't do it before you scope, so don't hold it already. If you're gonna scope in, let shift go, then start scoping, and when you start scoping, you press shift. And you have to learn the timing yourself. For me, it's automatically happening every time I snipe, but it is something you have to practice. I'm sprinting, I let the sprint go, I scope in, and I click it again. And sometimes it takes 20 years before it starts holding its breath. So that's about the timing and combination with your sprint key. It's a lot of practice to get it good, so. And you can hear it as well when she's holding her breath. So if you don't hear your character inhale and hold it, that means you're not holding your breath, and you have to re-click your shift key or your holding breath key. There you go. Perfectly stable. This took a while. accurate. So that's the weapon sway and holding your breath. For quick scoping, it's important to know how to center. So if you're, this is the middle of the screen where I'm looking at is where my bullet will go when I scope in. So I'm holding my breath. This is the middle of my screen. And I want to be looking where I want to shoot has to be in the middle of my screen. And when you see an enemy, quickscoping is kind of notoriously bad in this game right now because of the added sway to the game. But if you combine the advice and tricks I gave you, you will be able to do this. Let me check. I want to shoot right here. There's always a little bit of correction while you quickscope. So you look to your enemy. Let's say this lamp is my enemy. I look to it, and when I start scoping in, I see it in my scope. And when I start seeing it in my scope, I hold my breath. And I move my mouse to be able to hit it. So it went to the right top, I took it back down. It's really hard to explain, but that's what you have to practice to get good at this game for quickscoping. And I honestly don't know how I can explain this better to you guys. So if you have any advice, let me know in the comment section below and I'll make a follow-up video to correct myself. But that's how I quickscope on feeling. So I always correct myself a little bit. It's my playstyle and I don't really do this and just shoot. That's almost not possible in this game anymore if the enemies are a little bit of range. If he's close up, sure, I can just do this and hit him. No problem, because the enemy target is big. But if he's at a distance, you have to hold your breath to aim properly, in my opinion. Well guys, that's the end of part 2 for this video. In the next part, we are going to talk about the movement, positioning and some more stuff. So if you have any suggestions for the next video or questions about part 2, let me know in the comment section below and I'll get to it at the beginning of the next video. And yeah, let me know if you enjoyed it. Smash like, subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.